Why is Birmingham introducing a clean air zone? I'm William Bloss, Professor of Atmospheric Science at the University of Birmingham. Like many cities in the UK, Birmingham has challenges with two key air pollutants, nitrogen dioxide gas, or NO2, and fine particles, PM2.5, that are small enough to inhale deep into our lungs. We care about this because these air pollutants cause significant health impacts. They cause respiratory and cardiovascular illnesses, and their impacts are felt particularly on some of the most vulnerable segments of our population, the elderly and the young. Across the UK, air pollution causes something like 28,000 to 36,000 excess deaths each year, maybe 1,000 in Birmingham. So what should we do? To reduce these health impacts, we need cleaner air, and we need to reduce the emissions of the air pollutants that affect us here in Birmingham. And for NO2, that source is dominated by road transport, in particular older diesel vehicles. So we need policy action to reduce emissions from such vehicles and encourage their replacement with cleaner alternatives. And of course, such policies also need to provide viable transport alternatives and avoid undue impacts on the least advantaged sections of society. The UK has an air quality objective, or a legal limit, for NO2 of 40 micrograms per cubic metre, measured as an annual average. And NO2 levels in Birmingham city centre exceed this level, hence the need in law for the clean air zone. But we know from the latest science that there's no threshold for health effects, and that we will gain in terms of improved health from any reduction in pollutant levels. So the key question is, will it work? What will happen? We know the policy is designed to target the most polluting vehicles, and we certainly expect journeys undertaken by those vehicles to fall within the clean air zone. But what we don't know yet is how we'll respond, how people will change their behaviour or otherwise overall. So we'll be looking at the air quality within the clean air zone, and also looking to measure the change in exposure from people living within the clean air zone and those living around the periphery to assess the impacts overall. At the university more generally, our research is measuring real-world on-road vehicle emissions and determining the chemical fingerprints of the fine particles in air so we can target and refine future policy measures in the most effective way. And in this way, we can help local and regional policies deliver cleaner air for everyone.